Hi everyone, I'm going to just show you how to, you can on Linux update your firmware on a ThinkPad T470. So I'm using Fedora or Fedora 32 specifically, but you know the process should work with any Linux distribution, I guess as long as you have systemd, and potentially with other laptops as well, ThinkPad or otherwise, right? So the way this shows up is that, you know, inside GNOME software under the updates tab, you will see a list of device firmware that needs to be updated. Now, since I've already updated all of these, you know, it doesn't show it to me in my GNOME software updates tab, but I had taken screenshots and, you know, use that to just explain what happens. So as you can see, there are three device firmware updates to be applied: one to the Intel management engine, one to the Lenovo system firmware, and then one to the Thunderbolt controller. Now, if you click on any of these, it actually shows you some details. So I'll just show you that, screenshots of that. So this is the update to the system firmware. As you can see, there are two updates, you know, 1.62 and 1.63 that need to be applied with some details of what is being fixed. This is the fix to the Intel management engine. There's a list of CVEs. And this is the one for the Thunderbolt firmware. So I think important to, you know, read these, because apart from describing what the fix is, in this case there's actually a firmware that can damage your hardware, that is the issue. There are also important notes like this, where it says please do not plug the Thunderbolt device to your system while updating. So it's important to just read these before you hit update. Now before going into how I did the update, just want to quickly explain, you know, how did these particular firmware updates appear on my device? You know, from where did they get pulled down? Who had created them? And how can I trust that I can apply these? So for that, what I'll do is switch over. Yep. So this is the website. It's called LVFS, or the Linux Vendor Firmware Service. And what it is basically a place for manufacturers to upload certified updates to firmware, and then, you know, from this service on your laptop, which is called fwupd or firmware update manager, you can then pull these down and apply them from this site here. Yeah? So what this does is you can enter your machine number, so I'll say T470, and it shows me, yep, these are all the updates that are to be applied. And what is interesting is that if you click down, so if I say the system update, you know, shows me there was 0.163 released on 14th May, stable, blah blah blah. It also has details about, you know, it is cryptographically signed, was added by Lenovo, it can be verified after flashing, it has no attestation checksums. So, you know, you can say for 0.163, 0.162, I can, you know, read through what is happening. The same, I can also look at the Intel management engine or ME firmware update. Yeah, and as you can see here, it also has these CVEs that we saw on the GNOME software, but more importantly, you can click on these and it will show you the, you know, NIST details on this particular CVE. Yeah, so that's handy. And lastly, for the Thunderbolt controller, yeah, here we go. It was added by Lenovo, is cryptographically signed, but cannot be verified after flashing. So in any of these warnings, you can just see what that means. When devices are flashed with the new firmware, device will self-check that the data has been returned, but some devices just write new data and hope for the best. So that's what's going to happen for the Thunderbolt controller. And as we'll see, that doesn't work out too well. But hey. Okay, so that was LVFS. Now, Intel had done an interesting presentation at FOSDEM. And what it talks about there, you know, it talks about the problem statement that, you know, it's difficult to get users to apply firmware patches, and it's, you know, kind of a even more complicated process on Linux. So for example, you would have had to either have a Windows partition or, you know, download a specific DOS based utility onto a pen drive and apply it. But now, you know, this LVFS is going to make it a lot easier. And this is what the overall process looks like, right? So the vendor creates and then signs this UEFI capsule, publishes it on the LVFS website, and the fwupd manager that we will see shortly It basically pulls it down and applies it. Yeah. There are some more details. So this is the structure of the UEFI capsule. You know, the payload has the firmware, etc. I think the most interesting slide is right at the end. Let that go. Oops. Yep, vendor support for LVFS. So as you can see, starting from what, to 2016, a large number of vendors have started supporting LVFS. For example, Western Digital in 2019. But you know, right now, if I see, when we get into it, you'll see I have a WD NVMe drive, but there's no firmware update available for it. I'm just hoping that they're in a testing phase and it should be available soon. Yeah. So that's done. So let's just look at what we have, right? Okay. So obviously, I've done all of these updates, so I can't really show you the process of updating, although I have recorded screenshots and videos, so we can look at that. But I have captured all the output. So for example, the first thing that you would need to do is called get devices. So I'll say fwupdmgr get-devices. What this does is it gets all of the devices on the system that fwupd can potentially update. Yeah. So Thunderbolt controller, the embedded controller, the Intel management engine, the system firmware, the UEFI firmware, and the Western Digital NVMe drive that I have. Potentially even this can be updated. Yeah. What else? So there are some device flags, as you can see. You know, a lot of these, they require AC power or require a reboot after install, while some don't. So for example, the Thunderbolt controller update does not require a reboot, but you know, we'll see how that actually went. Okay. I had a problem with updating the Thunderbolt controller, so it's just telling me that, you know, do I want to submit a report? Not at this time. Yeah. So this is the, as I said, fwupd manager get devices. It'll list your devices for you. Right. The next thing you would do is you would hit refresh. Yeah. Manager refresh. So what this does is it actually reaches out to the LVFS server and pulls down a metadata file saying, okay, these are the latest updates or what have you. And then you can, you know, it'll do a compare and see, do you need an update or not. Sorry. Fwupd manager refresh. Okay, since I ran it a short while back, let me just do force. Here we go, it's forced it. Yeah, and it says four local devices are supported. So basically, when it reached out and pulled down this metadata file, it found that I think the UEFI and the Thunderbolt controller, you know, Western Digital, they are not supported by LVFS, the others are. Right. Now, once you have done this, you've got the latest metadata. Now, what you want to do is get the updates themselves, right? And that is done through, well, get updates, but again, so you would have done fwupd manager get updates basically, but obviously I can't do that now because I already applied those updates. So what I can show you is the output. Yeah, so this was the update. So what it said was, here we go. So get updates, it told me I have an update for the Thunderbolt controller. And here it gives details on what that update is. Yeah, fix that. The same thing we saw on the GNOME software tab. Please do not plug the Thunderbolt device. Yeah, the Intel IME. So here it's a corporate IME update. The list of, so same details that we saw there on GNOME software. And then when I look at the system firmware update, you know, in this tree you can see there are two updates: 0.163, 0.162. Da 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 da. Yeah, some details and all of that. So this is the get updates. What it also did was, it also showed me, that the embedded controller has the latest available firmware version, and the UEFI device firmware, and the Western Digital drive. There has no, you know, there are no firmware updates available on LVFS at all. Yeah. So basically, the vendor is not publishing them. Yep. Right. So once you have done this, then the next step is to actually update them. And the way you do that would be fwupdmgr update. Yep. Now what this would do is it would pull down, it would apply all of the updates, you know, for all three devices. I've done that once before. It's a bit nerve-wracking, so I'd recommend not doing that. And instead, what we want to do is apply the updates selectively, you know, one at a time. So if I just go back here, so the way I did it was I first applied the Lenovo system firmware update, then I applied the Intel management engine, and last Lenovo Thunderbolt controller. Yeah. Now, in order to be selective and, you know, pick out which one you want to update, the way you do that is use fwupd update manager update space and then the device ID. So if you want to get devices, if I just have get devices, so okay, not this stuff, right? So my system firmware has this device ID. Yep. So I just copy that, and I can now do fwupd manager update. Oh. Update. Yep, so that would now trigger the update of the system firmware. Now, as I said, I can't show you that now since I've applied it. So what I'll show you is the update. Yeah, six. So this is the output from that command. It downloads the firmware scheduling, and it says successfully installed firmware. But actually, that's not what has happened, right? What has happened is it has downloaded that update, but it has placed it at a place where it will now get applied at the next install, at the next reboot. And the way it does that, it is changes the EFI boot manager sequences, right? I'll just show you what they looked at the point after applying this, what that looked like. So if you do EFI boot manager minus V, yeah, it shows you the standard boot order, you know, saying okay, Fedora, then, you know, go to the USB CD, then go to NUAN9, which is the NVMe drive, etc. Anyway, the current boot was this one, which is it launched Fedora. Boot next, now if you see 0001, so this is what has changed. Yeah, and it says Linux update, firmware updater, this line. So what's going to happen after you get this, finish the update process? It is going to insert this entry, or, you know, update the boot order, so that next time you boot it, it will boot up this process, right? So what I did was I ran a reboot, and I have a video of that process. So let me just show you that. So system firmware update, this one. So as you can see, after reboot, the first thing is it found a capsule, added that capsule, and reset the system. Let's just see what that is here. So once this capsule was added and it reset the system, it now starts the process of actually applying the update. And as you can see, you know, it takes a long time. Yeah. So here we go. Yeah, flash utility. So there's a Lenovo specific utility for the system firmware, and it starts flashing. Let's just understand a bit more what's going on over here. So this, back to this handy presentation. Yeah, where is that slide? Yeah, here we go. So this is what is happening. So you have a normal boot. You know, then I ran fwupd manager update. It received the UEFI capsule and saved it. I then did a reboot. So that came back on, it loaded the UEFI capsule, and then it did a system reset. And now what is happening is the actual UEFI capsule updates are getting applied in the system. And once this apply process is over, it does a triggers a reset, and that then there's a verify process after that. You know, so that's the overall process. So if I just come back, yeah. Okay, here we go, total block. So anyway, let's skip forward a bit. A little more. Oh, done. Okay, so image flashing done. There we go. Now for some reason it goes through another power cycle, not sure why. Yeah, There'll be a very quick message that flashes up here. Come on. Yeah. Yep, you saw that? Okay, fine. It found something, it triggered on a reset, and now we should now see basically Fedora booting up again. Come on. Yep, there we go. So, you know, that was the process for what happened at the back. Now, what I did after that was I then triggered the Intel, you know, management engine update. Same process, you run fwupdmgr update, now give the device ID for the Intel management engine, and it goes through the same process. Let me just show you, I won't actually do it and show you, but idea is the same. You run that, then you trigger a reboot, and I'll just show you what it looks like, because it looks a little different. I mean, there's nothing very different going on, but it just looks different on the screen here. So you first get that capsule update message, you know, found new. So that process is still the same, but when it actually runs the update, it just looks a little different. Here we go. So you see, it just looks different, and now it's applying the Intel management engine update. Yeah, so just skip through this quickly. This too took a while, you know, as you can see, almost 2 minutes. And then it went through the standard reboot cycle, and that was the Intel management engine update applied. Yeah, that's Fedora booting up again. Okay. Now the third update, so we did the Lenovo system, we did Intel management, and the third update was the Thunderbolt controller. Now this one, a little more interesting. So as you can see, this is a critical fix to the Thunderbolt controller that Lenovo has published, actually Intel. And what it does is it solves a problem where the old firmware, it actually affects the hardware and it causes the USB-C port to stop working. So in your docks, HDMI output, system charging, all of that stops, and it affects a wide range of ThinkPads. Yeah. So, right. So that's what that third update was, and in terms of the way it is applied, was pretty much the same. You do fwupdmgr update, and then the device ID of the Thunderbolt device. The difference being that in this case, the update gets downloaded and just pushed to the firmware immediately. You don't need to go through that boot cycle, right? So let's look, see what that looked like. Yeah. So as it says here, downloading, it fetched the firmware, says restarting device, but that's where it ran into a problem. Let me just show you what the problem was. Right, failed to get the device after update, failed to wait for the, so basically the device did not come back after it ran the update. And as I said, you know, this update, it was done directly, it was not done through the UEFI reboot cycle. Yeah. Now basically the problem now was that I could not, so there's a command fwupdmgr verify, and you can use that to verify if that update has happened successfully. But at this time, as you can see, it failed to find the device, so I had no option but to reboot the system and just hope that it would get picked up again. That's when I ran into the second problem, which is that, you know, when I try to reboot, I get this message which says, you know, authentication is required. And what is happening in the background is that for the manager, during this firmware update process, it prevents the system from being, you know, rebooted or put to sleep, and it does that through the systemd inhibit process. Right, now again, that inhibit has gone away now, but I can show you what it looked like at the time. So if you were to do at that time systemd -inhibit --list, you would have seen this output. So basically, as you can see, fwupdmgr has put an inhibit on shutdown, sleep, any of these things, and the reason given is firmware update in progress, which makes sense. Now, you don't want to do any of these things while a firmware update is going on, but in this case the problem was that the firmware update had crashed and you know, it had locked up the shutdown process as well, so I had to force the shutdown by, you know, the sudo password at that point. And then when it came back up, thankfully the, you know, USB-C controller was working, thank God. And fwupdmgr, if I just do get devices, so as you know, the update in question was updating it from version 4 to version 20. So if I do get devices, as you can see, the current version, as you see, 20. Yeah. Okay, do not upload it this time. There's another command you can run, fwupdmgr get history. Yeah, and over here you can see the sequence of updates that I did apply, and the last one being the Thunderbolt controller, you know, it update state failed, update error, so and so. Yeah, any case, it's working fine now, not to worry, but you know, did lead to some nerves at that time. So that's it, I guess. Hopefully, you know, you found this guide helpful, and as I said, you know, it should be useful whether you're using Fedora or some other Linux distribution, and potentially even on other you know, laptops than ThinkPads, although ThinkPads are pretty well supported. You know, as you have seen, the number of vendors who are working on this, up here, come on, there we go. Yeah, pretty sure most of the major software, hardware vendors are represented here now. So it shouldn't be long before you start getting updates through this. The only thing I've seen is, you know, older hardware is not getting supported, partially because it doesn't support UEFI, but even otherwise. So for example, if you go back to LVFS and search for T460, you do get some very basic minimal updates. But if you go back one more generation to T450, yeah, it's not there. Okay. And the other thing to just highlight is, you know, keep in mind the Thunderbolt controller issue. So just need to be careful while buying secondhand ThinkPads, which is what I do usually, you know, to make sure that the firmware update is applied and the USB-C Thunderbolt port is actually working. Because, you know, as it says on this page, after around 6 to 12 months of typical usage, that piece of hardware can fail if this firmware is not applied. Okay, and on that note, thanks a lot. I hope you found it useful. Bye.